back up the very steep Fillmore Street to Originals Vinyl at the top of the hill, and to an ice cream parlor as well. Really steep. All right, here I am back in the Fillmore District at Originals Vinyl. This time I'm going to flip through some records. All right, guys, back again, back home in the record room in Reno, and we had a wonderful trip to San Francisco. We drove from Reno to San Francisco. It's about 4 hours over the Golden Gate Bridge. Sean loves it. So does my wife, June. And we landed at the Palace of Fine Arts. That's where Sean wanted to go. He's 7, almost 8 years old. He loves world landmarks. And the Palace of Fine Arts, what you saw in the video at the very first, was built in 1915, and it's in the Marina District. It's really cool. You can walk around there. And then we went and had lunch on Baker Street at a French bistro. It was excellent. And then got in the car and chugga-chugga-chugga up Fillmore Street, the very steep Fillmore Street, going up the hill into the Fillmore District. We parked on the corner of Fulton and Hayes, walked 2 blocks up. On the corner of Fulton and Fillmore we parked. Walked 2 blocks up to Hayes to Originals Vinyl. And Originals Vinyl is owned by Matthew, and he has a new guy working there, Ryan. He was very, very helpful. He has 3 ultrasonic cleaning machines. And I asked him to spin a record, and he says, sure, let me put that on. So he spun. It was Electric Flag, which I'll get to in just a moment. And so I love the experience of that store. Very small. I didn't have a lot of time. Sean and June ended up waiting for me. So I did a power flip, and I went to the $5 bin underneath first. I'm going to dive right into this. This is really cool. I have 12 records. I spent all of $112. So what? I don't know, about $9 a record or $10 a record. So first off, I was missing Punch the Clock by Elvis Costello. This was $5. I already took the tag off, and don't sweat it. You know, they do put the tags on, and I know that drives a lot of, you know, collectors crazy, but they come off easily, and not a problem for me. And this album, you know, every day I write the book. Fantastic. King of Thieves, Charm School, What Shipbuilding. There's the songs. So pleased to have this. This is U.S. Press, of course. I mean, it was $5, and it's on the Red Columbia. And next, there was Get Happy as well. And this has I Can't Stand Up for Fallen Down, and it has Opportunity, so many great, High Fidelity, Riot Act, so many great, Motel Matches, so many great songs on Get Happy. Elvis Costello, really pleased to have this one. So I'm really fattening up my Elvis Costello collection, and this is cool. That's the original inner sleeve. And all of these records are cleaned on ultrasonically on his machine, even the $5 records. Very, very cool. And I couldn't pass up. I saw this for $5. It's a sealed Greg Kinn band. Now, I have this, but this one, you know, obviously my very cleanest copy. Now, let me show you the hype. And that's the little price sticker on there. And the back. And I'm turning Japanese. The Vapors, Nuclear Days. I never had this record. Never, ever, ever. Great to add this to my 80s collection. Awesome. And there's the boys in the band. Let's see what this one looks like. Oh, it's on, let me show you. It's on UA. And I was so pleased to find this for $5. East Side Story, Squeeze. Tempted is on here. So many great songs. Squeeze does not write bad songs. I found that out. One day, for 2 hours, I was working in the record room, and I listened to Squeeze all day long, remodeling the record room. And I just marveled at the fact that I hadn't heard a weak song out of, I don't know how many, 33 songs, more than that. So Squeeze, East Side Story. And none of these, I don't believe, are UK Press. Now, I'm going to show some more West Coast sound, country rock, Commander Cody. We're talking some San Francisco sounds. And his Lost Planet Airmen. Love this record. My favorite Commander Cody record of them all is Country Casanova. And Cody's standing in front of a Lincoln Continental, you know, near a cow pasture. Cool record, but this is a good one, too. This is live. And there they are, boys in the band. And this is from 1972. And next up, Russell Smith with Amazing Rhythm Aces. And this is Stack Deck. And this has Third Rate Romance on it. Never had this record. I have about three other Amazing Rhythm Aces records. And I love this band. Absolutely. Glad to have this one. And again, this was $5. There's the back cover. I will bring the heat shortly. Don't worry. Now, this was $3 of ultra clean Jackson Browne Running on Empty. And reason why I picked this up is Rich Strickler, Sam St. John, and myself, we're going to do a rundown of the Running on Empty album soon. Yeah, we're going to do that, I'd say in about a week or 10 days. That'll be fun. And there's Jackson on the back. And again, this is a $3 record, and he cleaned it on the machine. Now, here's a band. This guy, both of them played with John Mayall on Turning Point and Empty Rooms from 1969. And that's the Mark Allman Band. This is Mark Allman 2. And I remember in the 70s, late 70s, I used to listen to What Am I Living For? I love that song. And that was on Rising, I believe, the record after this. I would love to pick up that record. This is, you know, they're jazz, rock, folk, popular. This is great music. I eventually want to get all of their records, especially the first three or four. So Mark Allman 2, this is sealed, and this is on Blue Thumb Records. And there they are. Yeah, those boys played with a lot of great musicians. Now, these are some a little spendier. This is a $20 record. I've been looking for a nice copy of Tupelo Honey for a long, long time, and I found it. And I know you're looking at that sticker like, why do they do that? Well, they have to. They're a record store. They, you know, inventory and theft, all that. But this one, Van recorded this in upstate New York at Woodstock, and then he moved to Marin County, which is just on the north side of the Golden Gate Bridge. You know, it did so well in the U.S. This is right around 1971, and really it did so well here because country rock stylings, you know, country, you had Blue-Eyed Soul, a little funky, but really some, you know, some laid-back West Coast sound leanings. This is just wonderful, wonderful record. This is, I'd have to say, I'm not a big ranker or rater, but about my top three for Van Morrison records. So happy to have this. And he recorded this in San Francisco. First of all, at Wally Heider. That's a big studio. There's a lot of great records on the West Coast that were recorded there. And then he finished this record up at Columbia. And there's Van. So Tupelo Honey, Van Morrison from 1971. And then this was so cool. This is Clear Spot, guys. Captain Beefheart and his Magic Band. Fantastic to have this. This was $5, and it's such a clean copy. I only have two or three Captain Beefheart records, and, you know, honestly, I have this on CD, but it's been so long since I've heard it. It's a highly touted Beefheart record, and I'm going to dive into this really soon. I think, you know, just right after this video, I'll spin it. And here's the songs here. And let's see what we have. This is cool. This is on a very, very heavy Reprise Showboat label. Captain Beefheart, Clear Spot. Next, I couldn't pass this up because I'm really into 90s bands. This is a band from Arizona, and this is Meat Puppets, and this is Out My Way. And to get a Meat Puppets on vinyl, I'll take it. I'd really like to get Meat Puppets 2. And what's that one, Into the Sun? Is that what it is? Anyhow, this is fantastic. And it wasn't really, you know, it was $18. I'll take it. And the boys recorded this in Phoenix. Love this band. And yes, a lot of us discovered Meat Puppets from Kurt Cobain, when he really gave a big shout out to the band and covered, I believe, one of the songs on his Unplugged album. And this is the record that that Ryan spun for me. I just had to hear it. It's a best of, but you have, guys, you have, you've got Barry Goldberg, Nick Gravanites, Buddy Miles, Harvey Brooks, and you have Michael the Man Bloomfield. That's the best of Electric Flag. And I only have two other Electric Flag albums, and this, it sounded great, you know, and of course he had cleaned it. So very happy to have this. And it was, it was $5. So yeah, if you're ever in San Francisco, go up Fillmore Street on the corner of Fillmore and Hayes and go to Originals Vinyl and say hi to Matthew for me. And let me show you the band. And the songs. Killing Floor is on here. All right, we're getting there. And then I've been looking for this album for a really long time. And it's $5. And that's Inagata Da Vida Baby, Iron Butterfly. So clean. This is a second press. I don't care. Look at that jacket. I'm stoked. So happy to have this. And in 69, when I was in sixth grade, I brought this record into my class with three of my friends. And my teacher was Miss Nelson in Bijou, California, South Lake Tahoe. And she let us spin this record. And we listened to the entirety of Inagata De Vida while having lunch in my sixth grade class. That was cool. What a cool teacher. And here's the back cover. And I got to do it. Ooh. Yeah, Doug Engel and band. Last one, guys. I wanted to fatten up my Rolling Stones. Bam! Rolling Stones Now. U.S. Press, super clean jacket. This was all of $18. So glad to have it. I have this on CD, but yeah, I still want to get a few more Rolling Stones records. I have a number of them, but this is a great gem to add to it. So, back cover. And let's show you the wax. And if you're in the UK, you'll see what a US press, well, there it is, similar to your pressings in the UK. Well, listen, hey, thank you so much for watching. Again, wonderful trip to San Francisco. Our drive back, we missed a really big snowstorm by about 3 hours. When we got home, it snowed here in Reno overnight, and it definitely was snowing over Donner Summit. I don't mind driving in the snow. I'm used to it growing up at Lake Tahoe, but it was nice to have a nice, easy drive back home. All right, see ya. On the way home, I'm gonna go through Sacramento, up over Donner Summit through Truckee, and on home to Reno.